What is Audacity? Audacity is cross-platform sound editing and recording software. It is available for free as open source software. Audacity runs on Microsoft Windows, Linux, and Mac. Audacity has been downloaded over 76 million times. Let's download and install Audacity. Open a web browser like Internet Explorer. In the address bar, enter audacity.sourceforge.net and press enter. On the Audacity homepage on SourceForge, click the Download Audacity 1.3.14 beta link. Under the Recommended Downloads section, click the Audacity 1.3.14 installer link. On the Download Information bar, click the Run button. This will download the file and then automatically start the installer. It's about an 18 megabyte download, so it should be fairly quick. Once it's finished, on the Download Information bar, click the Run button. On the Select Setup Language window, click the OK button. On the Welcome screen, click the Next button. On the Information screen, click the Next button. On the Select Destination screen, click the Next button. On the Select Additional Tasks screen, click the Next button. On the Ready to Install screen, click the Install button. On the Information screen, click the Next button. On the Completing the Audacity Setup Wizard screen, deselect Launch Audacity, and then click the Finish button. You can start Audacity in one of two ways. Option 1, double-click the Audacity icon on the desktop. Option 2, click the Windows Start button, All Programs, and then click Audacity. Before we get into using Audacity, we're going to download two additional pieces of software that are needed to export files into MP3, M4A, and other formats. Click the Edit menu, and then Preferences. On the Preferences window, click the Libraries tab. Next to where it says LAME MP3 Library, click the Download button. Click the LAME Download page link. Scroll down to the For Audacity on Windows section, and then click the LAME for Audacity on Windows link. On the Download Information bar, click the Run button. This will download the file and then automatically start the installer. On the Setup LAME for Audacity window, click the Next button. On the License Agreement screen, read the License Agreement. Click the Radio button to select I accept the agreement, and then click the Next button. On the Select Destination Location screen, click the Next button. On the Ready to Install screen, review the information and then click the Install button. On the Completing screen, click the Finish button. To be able to convert files to M4A format, which is used by the iPod, iPhone, and iPad, you need FFmpeg installed. Back in Audacity on the Preferences window, in Libraries, next to FFmpeg Library, click the Download button. Click the FFmpeg Installer link. On the Download Information bar, click the Run button. On the Setup FFmpeg for Audacity window, click the Next button. On the License Agreement screen, read the License Agreement. Click the Radio button to select I accept the agreement, and then click the Next button. On the Select Destination Location screen, click the Next button. On the Ready to Install screen, click the Install button. On the Completing screen, click the Finish button. Open Audacity back up. We now need to locate both of these installations by clicking the Locate button. OK. Click the No button. We can now see that the versions are listed for LAME and FFmpeg. Click the OK button. We are now able to export audio to any of the available formats in Audacity. The first thing you should know about Audacity is how to undo changes. If you make any change, and you don't want to keep it, you can press the Undo button to remove the last change. Let's open an audio file to work with. Click the File menu, and then Open. Browse for, select the file, and then click Open. Let's take a look at some of the basic interface options. In the top toolbar, we'll have a look at the options from left to right. Starting on the left, there are your basic controls like play, pause, skip to beginning, skip to end, and record. Next, you have some tools like selection tool, envelope tool, draw tool, zoom tool, time shift tool, and multi-tool mode. Next, you have the output level meter and the input level meter showing the audio levels. The second toolbar contains some additional tools and settings. Here you have the output volume slider and the input volume slider. This will adjust the master volume for both the input and output. Next you have the cut, copy, paste, trim, and silence buttons. And then you have undo and redo options, which either undo the last thing you changed or repeat the last command you used. Sync lock tracks. Then there are the zoom in and zoom out buttons, which will zoom you into the audio clip, showing more detail of a smaller clip of the track. Once you are zoomed into the track, you can use the slider at the bottom to move around within the clip. Last, there are the Fit Selection and Fit Project buttons. If we shrink the audio clip, we can use the Fit Project button to fill the window. The third toolbar contains hardware and device settings. You can set the audio host you prefer. By default, I'm using MME. But you could also select Windows Direct Sound. The output device determines where you hear the audio from when it's played back. For the input device, you can select the microphone that you want to work with. And finally, the number of channels you want to use. Here we have the option for 2 stereo input channels or 1 mono input channel. Below the 3 toolbars, we have the bar that shows the time in the clip, in minutes and seconds. Let's take a look at the video clip itself. In the far left, you have information on the audio clip, like the sample rate. Below you have buttons to either mute the clip or change the clip to solo. The sliders below will adjust the clip's gain, making it louder or quieter, and the center to adjust the volume levels between the left and right channels. At the bottom, you can click this button to shrink the clip to make room for other clips. You can click it again to make it full size. There is also a menu if you click on the clip's title, but we won't go into that now. Since we're only working with one clip, let's make it take over the whole window so we can see the audio waves better. We'll click on the bottom of the window, drag, and then release it when it's full size. Now let's zoom in at the beginning of the clip and perform some basic editing. Click the zoom in button. You want to make sure you're able to see well. If it's zoomed out too far, you won't be able to work with the clip as detailed as you would like this. And if you zoom in too much, you'll only be able to see one or two words at a time. I like to have it zoomed to about this level. The effects menu contains most of the editing tools you will use in this program. There are two things I like to do to be able to work with the clips easier. First, since the two channels have the same audio, I click and drag to the bottom of the channel so it takes up the entire screen. You can still see the second channel, but it's very small. And now, if we click at 00, it'll actually zoom in on the waves. If you zoom in too much, you can left-click here and it will zoom you back out. Clicking it once is usually fine for me. If we look at the clip, we can see that it's not centered at 00 like it should be. To resolve this issue, we'll click the Effects menu, and then select Normalize. On the normalize window that opens, ensure that only the remove any DC offset center at 0,0 vertically is selected, and then click the OK button. We can now see that the clip is properly centered at 0,0. Now the mic that I use is a wireless gaming headset, and it's not of the best quality. There's always a ton of background noise in the clip. Thankfully, there's a great noise removal tool. Now before we open the noise removal tool, we need to select the sample portion of the clip to use as a template of what the background noise sounds like. We want to select the longest portion of the clip where the only noise is the background noise. The beginning of the clip works rather well because there's a few seconds of silence. Click and drag the selected size. Now click the Effect menu, and then Noise Removal. On the Noise Removal window, click the Get Noise Profile button. This will tell Audacity to use this as the noise sample for this clip. If we ran the Noise Removal tool again now, with just the beginning selected, it would only remove the background noise from that small sample. To remove all the background noise, click the bar to the left of the clip. We can now see that the whole clip is selected in gray. So with the entire clip selected, click the Effect menu, then Noise Removal. You can play around with adjusting the settings here as you like. The one option we will cover is the Sensitivity dB option. The higher the setting, the more noise removal it will perform. If you move it too high, it will start to distort the voice you want in the clip. The happy medium for me seems to be around 5. Now click the OK button. Now if we look through the clip, we'll see that the audio levels for the most part are about the same. However, there are parts like here where it's louder than the rest of the clip. Normalizing the audio will make it easier to listen to. This part of the clip has a loud spike that we're going to normalize. Let's listen to this part of the clip first to see what we're starting with. Notice there's a loud spike in the audio level there. With the mouse, we'll select a loud section. With this selected, click the Effect menu, and then Amplify. It sounds a little counterintuitive, but Amplify can either increase or decrease the sound level. I like to set it to about -4 dB. That'll drop it by a little less than half a decibel each time. This will decrease it by a small amount, and you can just repeat it if you want it lower. With -4 selected, I'll click the OK button. We can see that it drops just a little bit there, and this is actually quite a high spike. Now we can go to the Effect menu again, and then click Repeat Amplify. But there's also a keyboard shortcut of Control and R at the same time. This repeats the last command you issued, which in this case will be Amplify. So just keep pressing that until it's about the right size. That seems pretty good there. Now if we listen to the clip, this audio clip will be... It sounds more like it should. It sounds pretty good now. Now you can remove parts of the clip entirely if you don't want them. Let's go back a little bit to where I had this cough. You select it with the mouse again. Click the Cut button. That will remove that section of clip from the timeline. Now you can also select parts of the clip, and rather than remove them from the timeline, you can click the silence button, and that will just silence out the audio at 0,0. Now let's take a look at saving the file. By default, saving the project saves another file with a .aup extension, and that saves a list of the changes you made to the clip. It only references the original audio file. It's not actually editing it as we're going through. Let's click the File menu, and then select Save Project As, On the Save Project As window that opens, select the Save location, and then click the Save button. To save the file in another format, you actually have to export the project as a new format and not save as. We'll click the File menu, and then select Export. On the Export File window that opens, change the name if you like, and browse to the location that you want to save the file. Now click the drop-down for Save As Type, and select any of the output formats that you want. For this tutorial, we're going to select MP3. And now click the Save button. The Edit Metadata window will open. You can enter meta tag information here, like the artist name, year, genre, and so on. Once you're finished, click the OK button. Here we can see that we have the original WAV file that we started with, but we also have the MP3 that we just created. This audio clip will be used to show. You should now have Audacity downloaded and installed, and have a good understanding of the basic interface and functions. You should be able to clean up an audio file to remove background noise, remove spikes, remove sections, silence, and then how to properly export that audio into the format of your choice.